said something last month that appears to have answered that question that I was asking a little more clearly. You said, quote, not everybody wants to vote. And if somebody is uninterested in voting, that probably means that they're totally uninformed on the issues. Quantity is important, but we have to look at the quality of votes as well. What is a quality vote, as you put it?
Quality vote is a legal voter who says, I want a ballot. That's the quality vote.
You said it's someone who's informed.
What I was referring to, that there were two quotes that were commingled there. I made a statement, not everyone should vote. That statement was made in reference to fraudulent
ballots. I didn't
say
that's not the quote I pulled. This was not a commingled quote. This is what you said.
But that was also part of the narrative.
That is not what we're talking about here, so let's not change the subject. I'm talking about the quote that I asked you
about. It's the same interview in the same article, and my enemies have attempted to link the two of them together.
I'm not linking them, so answer that for me. What is a quality vote, as you put it? Because you said that if someone
is
uninterested in voting.
A quality vote is a non-fraudulent vote made by somebody who said, I want to vote, I registered, give me a ballot. That's a quality vote. Now, what
you said that they
be,
were,
I
you
don't
said,
that we
you said, you're talking about
people
being uninformed on the issue.
I don't think we should send people ballots if they're not interested. But if they're interested in voting, I would never stop somebody from voting.
You're going to miss people. You're going to miss people who have a right to vote. And as an example, I just want to point this out, and I know this to be true. You have a number of military installations in your state.
They have different military ballots. They have separate military ballots.
Are you aware that this bill will have the effect of purging military voters from your rolls? Military voters.
There's a separate military ballot that came up on the floor. That's another myth about the bill. There are separate military ballots.
This is a very real possibility.
Do you understand that there are separate military ballots? Because now you refuse to accept the fact that
I'm a military family.
You're dodging the
question. I'm a military family, so I'll tell you what I know. Which is
I'm talking Arizona, and I'll tell you what I know. There are separate military ballots that are not affected by this.
There are people who are registered, and I'm talking not just about in the military, because you know that people around someone in the military, it's not just a military member. There is a family around that military member. They can be legally registered to vote in Arizona. They may be somewhere else. They may have moved. And this will purge.
Excuse me, sir,
I'm not finished.
Okay.
This will purge some of them from the rolls. This has happened in my family while my husband was deployed, and only because I saw a final notice was I able to stop that. This will happen.
Can I answer now?
Of course.
Okay. First of all, if the family is overseas, that does not count these ballots we're talking about.
It doesn't have to be, sir, they're not just overseas, they move domestically.
But they're deployed outside of the state.
They move domestically, you know this. They can be registered to vote in Arizona and they can be in another state.
These are not the ballots we're talking about. Those are different ballots.
Those are normal ballots.
These are ballots that are sent to addresses in Arizona. Military families get different ballots. And by the way, you can't forward a early ballot mailed to an Arizona address.
I don't get a different ballot.
So how can the ballots we're mailing to Arizona residences not get to the other people when by law now they can't go there? They're different ballots you're talking about. We're talking about ballots that are mailed to non-military people who live in the state, who probably moved or are dead and aren't there to get them.
And there's no evidence that there is widespread voter fraud.
Hey, even if there wasn't, why would you send ballots to addresses where there's nobody there? It's a waste of money.
But you're going to purge people who may have moved.
Must we use spin words in this discussion?
No, that's not a spin word. That's just a fact.
We're removing people who haven't voted in any of the last four elections, local or municipal, after they don't reply to a letter they received after 3 months and after they don't respond to phone calls and emails from the election people.
Yes, to their old residence.
To prevent errors than we do with the actual
ballots
themselves.
To the phone number and the address.
And they come back with signature discrepancies.
To the phone number and the address that you have on record, which if they have moved on, you may not be tracking them correctly.
They write their phone number on the ballot when they vote.
And if they haven't voted recently, you're going to have a problem. As you are aware, people change phone numbers.
They still get the mail. Do you pay bills that come in the mail?
a lot of mail isn't forwarded. You're aware of that. There's a lot of problems with that.
Well, if it's, yeah, and if they move, they're not eligible to use that ballot.
That's not necessarily true. Look, that's not necessarily
true. You're
really
twisting the facts.
I'm saying for being purged, it's not the precinct. I'm talking about being purged from the early voting roll. I'm talking about people who are purged from that early voting list.
Can we use neutral names? They're being removed after multiple checks to make sure that they actually aren't there. They're not being purged.
That is how you describe it, sir. And we do appreciate
you
coming.
I'm not spinning it. So that's why I'm doing the truth. I'm not doing spin.
I'm not spinning it either.
Well,
Arizona
purge?
State.
What am I, Stalin? Come on, don't be ridiculous. This is why we can't have reasonable discussions across the political divide, because everybody wants to throw gasoline on what should be a critical intellectual discussion.
Sir, you're not being honest, and what you're saying doesn't even line up with what you have said about votes. You've talked about quality votes over quantity. I think that is loud and clear. Arizona State Rep. John Kavanagh.
Dishonest. Somebody who doesn't want to be registered to vote, who doesn't ask for a ballot, who doesn't follow politics, who doesn't know the issues, is a different voter from somebody like you, whose career is politics and knows everything. I'm not saying those people can vote, but if they don't want to vote, I'm not shoving ballots in front of them and forcing them to be registered against their will. I think that's freedom.
Their will is to be on that list. And, sir, one vote is the same as another vote. This is our right. This is our right as Americans. Sir, I'm going
to
have to leave it there.
If you don't pay
I'm going to have to leave it there, sir.
Your power off if you don't mail your bill in.
Sir, I'm going to have to leave it there with you. State Rep. John Kavanagh, thank you.
Okay, I thought so.